I've generated a Ruby on Rails application and we're going to deploy it to Heroku. You can generate your own by running Rails new, then your application name, then dash dash database equals PostgreSQL. Let's jump in. So first off, go to Heroku, sign up, sign in, whatever. Click new and create new app. And we're going to call this one deploying app. And we're going to, maybe Rails deploying app. And we're going to put it in Europe because that's nice and close to me. Cool. So the next thing we're going to do, so I'm going to make this a little bit bigger, is we're going to connect our GitHub app to our Heroku app. So I've got a little app here called Deploying to Heroku. I'm going to put that in there. Connect. Okay, we're going to enable automatic deploys. This means whenever we push to our master branch, it'll just do the deployment. And we're also going to run deploy branch. So that's going to deploy the latest copy of master. Okay, let's watch this go out. The first time you deploy, it will take about 5 minutes. This is because it has to download all the gems and all the yarn files. For future deploys, it will actually just cache them and it'll be an awful lot faster. Now that that build has completed, let's have a look at what Heroku's done for us. If we click the Resources tab, we can see it has detected we're a Ruby on Rails app and added a nice default starting the server command. It's given us a Postgres database for free, which is pretty handy. And if we go to Settings and Reveal Config Vars, it's also set up some nice default values for us, which is pretty handy. Let's have a look at our app. Oh no, something's gone wrong. Let's have a look at our logs and see if we can debug this issue. Okay, it looks like we are missing a table, so that probably means the migrations haven't run. The way we're going to solve this is by adding a file to tell Heroku that every time we push to GitHub and it does a deploy, we also want to run a command to run the migrations. So let's get on that. So I'm going to go to the root directory here, add a proc file. So the first one I'm going to add is web. And I'm going to make it match the current web resource we got there. This is because the proc file kind of manages what kind of command you want to run. So you need to define that one. And also I'm going to do release colon rails db migrate. Let's commit that in. Cool, I'm going to push it up. Awesome. Heroku's just picked up that we've pushed a change to GitHub and it's kicking off a deploy. So you'll notice it's now got this line right here, which means that it's detected that we've declared a release command and it won't release the new site until that command succeeds. If we go to activity, we can actually see the log of that command. We can see we've run rate db migrate and it's run the migration. And if I also go back to the site now, fantastic, it's up and running. That is the end of this video. I'm hoping you found that useful and enjoyable. I am MikeRogers0 on Twitter. If you have any questions, feel free to send me a message or drop a little comment underneath this video. Thank you for watching and I will catch you next time.